I swear that's greatness, greatness, greatness. You look into my eyes, you can see what I see. If you can say the world won't be the same without me, then we call that greatness, and that's a blessing. But wait a second, look, while we on the subject, let me ask a question.
Hello and welcome to the Uzzi Sports Show. I'm your host, Jared Valluzzi. And joined along me today, my guest, Ryan Duenkel out of St. John's College High School and the number one prospect in the 2024 class in high school lacrosse. Ryan, thank you so much for being here, man.
Thank you for having me. Appreciate it.
Hey, I'm glad you're able to make it on. And you've had a tremendous career so far. I mean, looking back at your freshman year, you know, you played on the team and led the team in points just as a freshman. I mean, what was it like playing on one of the top teams in the country at such a young age?
I mean, I kind of wasn't really expecting much my freshman and sophomore year, really. I knew I had so many threats around me, like Luke Roa, Gavin Kelly, Matt, and Mac all ended up being like unarmed All-Americans. So, I mean, you can just see like the power like we had. So I was really trying to do much, just do my role. And, that year I was kind of more of an assist guy since like I was a little freshman. I was kind of scared to go in kind of. So I was more like dishing it out to those guys. And it was just like so easy because I threw it to them. They could put in the back of the net each time. So made my life way easier.
Yeah, and then your sophomore year, you know, you played with some of the same guys. And, you know, some people say that was one of the best high school teams, you know, put together. What do you think made that team so special?
I think what made it special is our freshman year. And then we built up all that chemistry. And then my sophomore year and their senior year, those 22s, we kind of put it all together. And in the fall, we weren't even that good. Like, I didn't even think we were going to be that good. And then it came springtime. We kind of just, like, we clicked, really. We built the team from that freshman year. So, like, all that chemistry, we kind of just put together. And we made it, like who we were.
And in your sophomore year, you know, you started really, really blowing up. And of course, your team did as well. What was your recruiting process like after that sophomore season, you know, heading into September 1st?
Yeah, so I got surgery on my hips in June and July. So I didn't play throughout the summer. And that was kind of, I was like, am I not going to get as many looks or what's the deal with that? But I remember vividly September 1st, Lars coming to my house. Right before school, and so that kind of like really well, Coach Tiffany, that kind of just really like had my eyes locked on Virginia because no other coach really spent that time and did that for me. Like, I mean, spent the hotel night before to come to my house, which kind of meant a lot. And yeah, knowing that my brother and my dad went to Virginia, I'm in state, I'm pretty close to home. I mean, it made it the offer seem like I couldn't turn it down. And I've been going there my whole life. I've been rooting for Virginia my whole life, every sport. So, I mean, it was kind of just an honor to be able to go there.
And, you know, joining you in the class above is McCabe Millen. You know, a lot of people talk about, you know, how Virginia has, you know, the two top recruits in each class. How excited are you to, you know, team up with him in the future?
I'm really excited. I mean, just the more power you have, I mean, the better the offense is going to be. I mean, even him and his brother, like this year at McDonough, they popped off because they have so much good talent. And I think that's what Virginia's going to bring with my class and McCabe's and him. I mean, it's kind of going to be hard to like stop us. I feel like, I mean, there's just so much firepower. It's going to be hard to game plan and go against us.
Yeah, I can't wait to see that. I mean, that's going to be when you get there. And, you know, speaking of recruiting and all that, everyone has so much positive things to say about you, but you know, one thing, you know, people bring up is, oh, well, lack of size, he's only 5'8". Well, I mean, clearly it hasn't stopped you now, you know, how you overcome, you know, people saying, oh, he's too small.
Yeah. It's kind of been like, since I was young, I've always been pretty small and I've kind of just tried to use it to my advantage, honestly. Like when you're small, you got a lower sense of gravity. Usually you're quicker, you're faster. So I'm not going to try to use my body as much, even though I'm going to try to put on some weight. I'm not going to try to use my body as much because, like, there's guys that are 200 and some pounds. I'm not going to try to bulldoze them. I'm going to try to use what my skills that I can to my advantage. And, I mean, look at Michael Sowers. Look at all, like, the small players in the PLL that use their size to their advantage. So that's what I try to do.
Yeah, I mean, it's pretty evident in your game tape and everything. And, you know, speaking of that, your junior year, of course, another amazing season. And I'd say, you know, there's like three guys, you, Owen Duffy, and McCabe Millen. Pretty much every game you played, there was cameras on you. Everyone, you know, expected a ton. How are you able to, you know, live up to expectations and play so well this year?
Yeah, so, I mean, I kind of started off playing lacrosse just for fun. And I try to keep that aspect, even though, like, sure, cameras are on you and stuff. Like, you play the game to have fun. You don't play the game to impress other people. You play the game for yourself. And you play the game to really have fun and be with your buddies. And that's what I try to do each game.
Yeah, that's awesome, man. You know, one game where I saw, I mean, you guys had a ton of fun was against Bullis. It looked like one of the craziest games of the year. I mean, you know, take me through that night.
Yeah, I kind of was getting pissed off the first half. We were running the same base offense. And I was telling coach, like, come on, like, let me get the ball a couple of times. Like, let me try to go at this guy. And so we were down the first half. I don't know how much we were down by. But I remember going to the second half, we were like, play unselfish, play as a team. And that kind of really stuck. We then ran a different offense. I got a couple touches, and then I was from the wing. So I got to go from the wing, which I love to go from. And so I got from the wing. We got a couple goals back. And then going into the fourth quarter, we were down one or tied. And then they started face guarding me. And we kind of hadn't come to that this year. Throughout the rest of the year, like, teams were face guarding me, like Gonzaga and I forget who else did it, but some other team did it. And I was like, I wasn't used to that really throughout the season. So we came to that. I was getting face guarded. Then my boy John Drayley netted two at the end with the freshman Brendan Dufour. And that put us up two. And then Bullis came back and hit one. And we were up 10-9 maybe. And so we ended up finishing out the game 10-9. It was a crazy finish. It was like a loose ground ball. Our guy might have been out of bounds, but they didn't call it. And so the game kind of ended. We got out of there, but that definitely was not our best game. But, I mean, it was definitely a fun game.
And, Ryan, of course, on your schedule, you guys played against Gonzaga. And, you know, people outside of the DMV area, you know, they probably, you know, they know it's a rivalry. But can you describe, you know, what it really means, you know, St. John's against Gonzaga?
Well, I think it might be the longest private school or Catholic rivalry to date in the U.S., I'm pretty sure. I know it's one of. So, I mean, it's got a lot of meaning to it. Throughout the football week, there's, like, pranks leading up to, like, the football game, literally, from school to school. So, like, you'll be pranking the other school. But that's not, like, really lacrosse. I mean, lacrosse is still a huge rivalry, and it always has. And we're all from the, like, close area, so we're buddies with the Gonzaga kids. So, I mean, it means a lot. It's a lot of bragging rights with you and your buddies. So I think it's definitely a huge rivalry, and you always got that circled on your calendar each every year.
Yeah, that's amazing. And on your schedule, after the St. Anthony's game, you know, unfortunately you guys didn't come out on top there, but you guys went on a run after that, and you won another championship. What was the key to all that success after that game?
Yeah, I think St. Anthony's played a huge part in our development after the year. I mean, we kind of learned what our bread and butter was and what we were good at. And our second half was always pretty bad. We never, like, had a complete game. And our second half against St. Anthony's and, like, throughout the year wasn't too good. We never, like, put a complete game together. And we tried to just play quarter by quarter, play by play. And, I think that's what it was. We also built more chemistry along with that. I mean, since, like, it's my first year playing with that attack line with Anthony and Charlie, we definitely built a lot more chemistry. And that was definitely crucial for our success.
Yeah, I mean, you know, ended up in a championship win, which was awesome. But now we're going to the summer. You know, it's summer ball time. What events are you going to, and what are you looking forward to?
So I played one event, Platinum Cup. It was fun. We got the championship there, and then we have Grade 8 this upcoming weekend, and then Naptown, which I'm really looking forward to do. And I got Angeles with my high school team, and then I'm playing for a pretty cool organization, Team Headstrong, in Lake Placid, New York. So I mean, that's got definitely more meaning to it, since, like, you're playing for kids that have cancer, and, like, you're playing for an organization that's just more than your club team, or your high school team. But I'm definitely looking forward to Lake Placid and Naptown and kind of this whole summer circuit. I'm just kind of being grateful for it because, I mean, I didn't have it last year. Like, I didn't get a chance to play. So I'm just with my boys, just trying to have fun, really.
What do you think is your favorite memory out of all those years when it comes to summer lacrosse?
Yeah, I think a favorite memory of mine when we were younger on this on Madlax, and you know, summer ball's like you win tournaments and stuff, but it's a lot about like the team dinners and the team camaraderie, like outside of lacrosse, like you're chilling in the tent with your boys, you're drinking Gatorade, orange slices. But I remember one team dinner, we were in Annapolis, and I don't know, it was me or like a couple other kids. We went on a boat, and we definitely were not supposed to be on these private boats, and the people like called our parents or the coach. And all of a sudden, I remember just being in the grass, like doing bear crawls and running in the grass outside of where we were eating dinner. And my dad kind of found out it was me, and it was not a good time for me. And I didn't think I was going to be able to play tomorrow the next day. And I was like, oh, wow, I just screwed myself over. Like, what am I doing? Like, I'm not going to be able to like win a championship with my friends. Like, that was like the biggest thing back then, like being able to play with your buddies. So I just remember not being able to play, I was like, oh no, like no way. But yeah, I think that's one of my top memories.
There's a question, you know, I think I'm gonna ask a lot of people all summer. If you could add one player, you know, anywhere in the nation, since you know so many guys throughout your lacrosse career, to come to St. John's and, you know, team up for your senior year, who would you pick and why?
I don't know. There's a lot of kids I'd pick. Draley, but he's already on the team, so I'd probably say Porter. I've played with him, you know, Porter Malkiel from Oregon. Yeah. Going to Princeton, I'd probably say him because I'd played with him when I was younger on our Madlax team, but we both left that team. I definitely say Porter. I mean, we're pretty good friends, so it'd be fun to play with him. And we kind of have play styles that are kind of similar, so I think it would be fun to play with like one of your good buddies. And the kid, you know, that would produce.
Yeah, no, that'd be so fun to watch if that happened. And, yeah. You know, you kind of also mentioned John Draley, and, you know, when a lot of people think of St. John's, you know, people mentioned you and him. What's the connection like between you two?
Yeah, we're best friends. So, I mean, when it comes to the field, I mean, it translates right to the field. So your head's up, you're looking for one. I mean, you know, he's going to put it in the net. So it's kind of nice having like one of your best buddies on the field to look forward to. And I don't feel like he's just an O-mitty. Like he can play both ways. He's hard-nosed. So I think that's what makes him pretty special. Like he's not just an offensive threat. He's going to play both ways. He's going to be on the wing. He's going to do whatever coach asks, which I think is kind of like a Swiss Army knife to the team, which like not many other teams have nowadays, which I think is special.
Yeah. And, you know, I got, you know, one more, you know, really tough question, but of course you're going into your senior year, hypothetical, of course, if you could schedule one game against anyone in the country, you know, your decision, who are you playing against and why?
I definitely probably say, Brunswick. I think there's always a lot of hype leading up to that team, like each and every year. So I think that'd be fun to play them. Because I don't know if St. John's ever really has played them, which they got a ton of talent always. So I think that'd be a blast to play against. But yeah, we kind of just play whoever coach tells us to play, though.
Yeah, of course. Well, you know, that'll do it. Ryan, thank you so much for coming on the show today. I really appreciate it. And everyone, if you like this content, make sure to subscribe, follow my social medias. There's a lot to come this summer. So thank you so much for tuning in. I'm Jared Valluzzi. Always compete.
Oh, yeah.